various tools required during installation: heat gun, cutter, scrapping tool, vinyl tapes, ratchet spanner, screwdriver, measuring tape, and markers. Note before you start, confirm that the system is de-energized and properly grounded to ensure safety. Let us now look at the correct procedure for installing straight-through joint kits. Step 1. Cable identification and length designation. Designate one cable as the longer end, called part A, and the other as the short end, called part B. Since the insulating tubes will overlap, the center of the joint will not have equal lengths of cables on both sides. Step 2. Marking the surface preparation. The measurement varies depending on the voltage rating, that is 11 kV to 33 kV. On part A, measure and mark 1100 to 1400 mm from the open end, called point 1, and then add another 200 mm, called point 2. On part B, mark 450 to 700 mm, called point 3, and then add another 100 mm, called point 4. Step 3. Pre-installation of protective tubes. Insert the four protective tubes onto one cable before jointing begins. This will avoid last-minute complications. Arrange the tubes with the longest tube last and the shortest first for a smooth process. Step 4. Armour removal and insulation stripping. Secure the metal four spring at point 1 and 3. Cut and remove the outmost insulation layer to expose the armor. Now strip away the exposed armor up to the metal four spring. Measure 50 to 100 millimeters from point 1 and 3 based on the voltage rating and place another metal four spring. From these points, strip the inner insulation and remove the fillers. Step 5. Core exposure and metal screen preparation. Once the inner insulation is removed, wrap the vinyl tape at the tips of the cores to prevent unwrapping of the metal screen. Measure 310 mm from end of the core. Apply vinyl adhesive tape. Strip the metal screen from the tip of the cable to the vinyl tape mark. Step 6. Semiconducting layer removal. Locate the semiconducting layer and measure 50 mm from the last vinyl tape. Now, scrape off the semiconducting layer up to this point. Step 7. Conductor exposure and connector preparation. Expose the bare conductor according to manufacturer's specified insertion length and apply vinyl tape over the conductor for a snug connector fit. Step 8. Stress control tube installation. Polish the exposed insulation layer with manufacturer provided sandpaper and clean it with cotton cloth and solvent. Apply stress relief mastic tape over half of the semiconducting and insulating layers. Apply silicone grease on the insulation layers. Position the stress control tube over the semiconductive layer by 20 mm and heat shrink using a heat gun. Avoid excessive heating to prevent material damage. Step 9. Connector installation. Insert copper mesh into individual cores and slide the semiconductive tube and two insulation tubes onto each core. Join the corresponding phases using connectors, ensuring a secure fit through crimping or shear heat bolt tightening. Step 10. Insulation restoration around connectors. apply semiconducting tape tightly around the connectors. Apply filling mastic tape, ensuring a smooth transition between the insulation layer and the connector. Step 11. Stress relief mastic application. Wrap stress relief mastic around the step between the stress control tube and the insulation, covering a 5 to 10 mm area for a smooth transition. Apply grease on the connector and insulation area. Step 12. Heat shrinkable insulation tube application. Pull the insulation tube over the connector section. Use the flame gun to heat shrink the tube securely. Repeat the process for second insulation tube. Step 13. Semiconductive tube application. Position the semiconducting tube and heat shrink it carefully. Apply filling mastic tape and a semiconducting tape at both ends, overlapping with the copper screen to ensure a continuous connection. Step 14. Copper screen connection. Pull the pre-inserted copper mesh towards the center of the joint. Place braided earth wire around each phase core and secure it to the copper screen with a constant spring, ensuring there are no sharp edges. Step 15. Protective insulation application. Slide the shorter protective tube over the joint area, ensuring it overlaps the sheath, then heat shrink it in place. Wrap a layer of sealing mastic at the end of the shrunk tube. Overlap with another short protective tube and heat shrink to secure. Step 16. Armour earthing. Connect the armour ends with a braided earth wire. Tie them together using a constant spring. Ensure there are no sharp edges and add filling mastic if required. Step 17. Final protective insulation application. Apply sealing mastic to the ends of the outer sheath. Overlap with longer protective tube and heat shrink. Finish by wrapping sealing mastic at the end of the shrunk tube, overlapping it with another longer protective tube, then heat shrink for a final secure seal. The joint is now ready for services. This completes the medium voltage high shrinkable straight through joint installation at Axis Electrical Components. We have a team of over 50 experienced engineers specializing in the design, installation and testing of heat shrink materials. For further assistance, feel free to contact us, our heat shrink experts at axis-india.com.